Our final presenter is Bernard Evans from the Adelaide Medical School with a presentation entitled What Dragonflies Can Teach Us About Motion Adaptation.
Imagine that you are in your car and you're driving down the highway at 110 k's an hour. You're on your way to Melbourne and you come to a town that you've never even heard of. And the sign says 60, so you slow down. But this isn't 60, this is 30, 20. Oh, I could get out and walk at this speed. We've all been here. It's a real phenomenon. It's called motion adaptation. And it allows us to detect changes in speed, whether we're moving very quickly or very slowly. Now I want you to imagine that you're no longer in your car, that you're this little dragonfly, and you're hovering down by the side of the river, looking for food and checking out ladies, when, out of the corner of your eye, you see a blurish-looking blur, and you realize that it isn't food, and it isn't a lady, it's another guy and he wants your spot. So what do? You dive down to get underneath him, but he dives down to get underneath you, and now you're stuck in this death battle where you're ducking and weaving and spinning and bobbing and grab him by the tail, body slam him into the river, get back to your spot, and start checking out ladies again. All of this has happened in less than a second, and during this time you'll have pulled a 5G turn at 40 k's an hour. You'll have spun 1,000 degrees in less than a second. You'll have done this despite the fact that your brain is no larger than a grain of rice. But that's not the real problem. The real problem is when you build a speedometer out of brain cells, you need to pick a speed at which it works well. For humans, it's not a problem. Our brains are big, and so we can have as many speedometers as we like. But for insects, their brains are small, and they can only really pick one. If you like to hover in place, you pick a slow speed. If you like to zip from place to place or engage in death battles, you pick a fast speed. But what about our dragonfly? He likes to do both. How does he cope? By playing videos to dragonflies in a miniature dragonfly cinema and recording the electrical impulses from individual brain cells in the dragonfly's brain, I have discovered the answer. It's motion adaptation. Dragonflies use it slightly differently from us. They use it to tune their speedometers, allowing them to wind them up or drag them down to slower speeds, without replicating any hardware. In essence, they get three speedometers for the price of one. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, I'm not a dragonfly. Why do I care about this? Well, it turns out algorithms based on dragonfly vision are incredibly fast. And in 5 years' time, we are going to have drones flying around our skies and driverless cars driving around our roads, at least hopefully. And if these machines are to be reliable and safe, the people building them will be looking for solutions to problems such as navigation, object detection, and collision avoidance. The thing is, solutions to these problems already exist. You just need to know where to look, or perhaps the right question to ask, like, I wonder, how can this little dragonfly see? Thank you.